Hey, what's up, guys? This is Dylan Photography here, and right now we have a crazy unboxing, so let's get into this. Alright, guys, so we have the Viltrox adapter here. This is the $40 adapter. This isn't the expensive speed booster that a lot of people adapt to their Canon M series lenses. Canon M series cameras. So this is just the regular Viltrox adapter. I advise more people to get this one than I actually advise for the speed booster, because it doesn't crop it, right? Or as hard as, you know, already crop sensored cameras. So it kind of turns it into a full frame camera. And with that, I'll show you guys what the $40 one is. And now this, it just stays the same, but all it does is allows you to adapt EF lenses, which we have for you guys here today, that came in from MPB, and I will get to that one. But I'm gonna show you guys the Viltrox adapter when it comes in. I ordered this on Amazon, but you know, it comes with a little instructions. It's a nice colored box. I like this white and red. I like what Viltrox has going on over here with this white and red design. And now we have the adapter. So, I like that. It feels like this. It feels like really good quality. Holy crap. Man, it actually feels heavier than what I expected. I thought it was going to be really cheap and very plastic-like, but it is not like that at all. And as you can see, there's no glass in here, nothing that tampers with the zooming or any of the lens. But here you guys go. Whew. Now that baby looks clean, guys. Now this is the part that goes on to the M, like your camera, like the M series cameras. And this is where you adapt the EF lens. Now you can also put EFS lens with this one, because it has the white little box as well, and it has the red. So you can put EFS lenses on this adapter as well. But you know, I got the nice little 50 millimeter lens, 1.8 STM. And guys, there's a huge difference in between those lenses, right? So I was gonna get that plastic one, that Canon 50 millimeter 1.8 version 2 mark 2, and I didn't know there was an extreme difference, but there is an extreme difference. One has like a plastic, it's made very cheap, very plasticky, a lot of noise. But it was really a good deal on MPB. It was like $66. And I'm like, oh yeah, clear, I should go with this one. And then I look and it's like, you know, I'm more of a quality guy over than I am about just getting like the cheaper one. But as you can see here, I cheaped out on this, because really at the end of the day, I don't need a speed booster. And we are back. So we're going to remove the 18 to 55 millimeter 3.5 f/3.5 lens from the camera body. Make sure you got that to the sensor inside of it. A little nice little crop sensor in there. This one here, make sure this is safe. You know, that's one of my babies, a lot of that lens, guys. So this is the one that comes with part of the Viltrox. And now, here we go, guys. And then it adapts onto there. And now this is how it looks on the Canon M50. Man, it feels like it adds weight to it. I don't know, it feels a lot heftier. And I don't know, I came from DSLRs, so it does feel a lot. It's starting to feel like a DSLR, you know what I'm saying? It's starting to feel a little bit heavy. It feels like it added just a little bit of weight. It didn't feel like it added a really DSLR weight to it, but it does feel a little bit more camera-like now. But now, like I said, it doesn't really do anything. There's no little glass in here. This is the $40 one. And man, you guys can pick this up on Amazon, eBay, pretty much anywhere. I'm pretty sure B&H has one, you know. So you can really pick it up anywhere. And yeah, guys, this is what it looks like. This is nice because it covers it, but yeah. This is what it looks like on the Canon M50. It doesn't look bad. Again, I feel like it adds a little bit of weight. It feels like a grip. But I don't know. Now I kind of... It feels like my fingers are trapped when it's in here. It feels like, oh, shoot. Mm-hmm. But, yeah. This doesn't feel like it throw anything off. And it sits like this probably on a tripod. And not like with the one that comes with your camera. But, man, this adapter, quality wise, I say it's worth it. Really, if you really truly care about, man, I want my thing to look like a full frame and I want only EF lenses on my Canon M series, then I would say go with it. I really didn't go with it because it's like, there's a lot of options for EF, and again, I don't see myself keeping the Canon M50 for long. But I just, you know, wanted to get something that I could put a nice little 50mm 1.8 on, and probably put that 75 to 300mm 3.5 or f4 on here as well. And you could put all those EF lenses. We are on to the part two of this unboxing, guys, and we have, hopefully I can show you guys my best of the focus. We have from MPB, my favorite group of people. I love MPB, guys. Like, I don't have no affiliate links, nothing at the bottom, but man, I love MPB. I just love everything they do. Yep, this is my receipt. You guys already know from the last unboxings. And this is the lens. I love the box they put it in. I love how much they love themselves. But, man, let's get into this box right here. So we have the MPB box right here, guys. Just, man, I'm ready to adapt this. So let's go, guys. This is the 50mm 1.8 STM lens. And guys, there is a huge difference. There's a huge difference. If I didn't make that clear earlier, which I probably did, but there's a huge difference. There's the STM, there's the Mark II, there is Young Nuo, you can adapt. There's a Young Nuo Mark II. There's so many. There's so many. But yes. If I was to recommend one, get the 50mm 1.8 STM lens. A lot of people get confused on which ones they should get. Get that one. Going through the wrapping, going through the packaging. Look at this, look at that. Right. Take this little guy off. Get out of the trash. Man, look at this quality. This is what I'm talking. This is quality right here. So, remove this. Oh man, see now what the difference is. One has a from that Mark II, which is a very cheap one, and you're gonna probably find it on MPB for like $66-$70. It has a plastic little back ring right here, while it has while the STM version, and I don't know if you guys can see that, but the STM version has a metal. That is a huge difference. And man, this junk is big. Wow. Man, look at this. This is, it's quality. You can see this scissor ring right here. That's, this ring right here. Oh man. I'm so used to like zoom lenses and stuff. Like, I was like, oh my gosh, it's great, but And then you have the autofocus and manual focus adjustment. And this is the red little indicator to show that it's an EF lens. A lot of people don't know that. I didn't know that. So when you're doing a lot of research on EF lenses, just make sure you're looking for this red indicator, which will match with the red indicator on top of the Viltrox. That also goes for the speed booster. These work well on the speed booster, all red ones, but the white, that EFS, will not work on the speed booster. So, millimeter 1.8 STM lens. Man, this is clean. This right here is clean. And this is, I bought this from MPB with the good. I think this is good condition. And guys, for good, this looks clean. Like, MPB really doesn't miss on its conditions. I haven't seen them like mark it really. Like, the only say I would, reason why I say they mark it wrong is excellent for good condition is what I'm trying to say. And man, and they market it for cheaper, so it's just like they did the same thing with this. I got like a I got the Canon body for like a like new, and man, when that, it looked like it just came out the box. So I feel like they market wrong when it comes to that, because these things look really good and they deserve a lot more credit than they let on. Now we are going to adapt this to the Canon M50 body with the Viltrox adapter. You guys ready? Whew. Now this right here is the Canon combo that everybody freaks out about. Literally, when you search up the Canon M50 and then put 50 millimeter, they're gonna be like, ah, oh, this is the cinematic work of God and it's amazing. And I'm not gonna lie to you guys, it looks pretty cool. It looks like a real like camera. It feels like quality. It feels great. It feels very genuine. It feels very nice, you know? But yeah, it looks good. Looks great. It adapted well. It's very smooth. Y'all saw that. It was very well adapted. To remove it, I'm pretty sure it's this. Yep, you pull this lever and you remove it. Put it back on. Make sure red dot connects with red dot. And that adapts. Whew. Now that looks clean, guys. That looks clean. And again, you can't set it up, which bothers me. Maybe this piece needs to be gone. Maybe it needs to stay because it needs to be a part of it. But I don't know. Guys, I don't know. I just don't like how it can't stand. But this, they say this is like the best duo ever. So let's turn on the M50. Ooh. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Guys can hear that, but that is the noise. That is the noise, and the noise is very, it's not as loud as I thought it was going to be. Oh man, that 1.8, oh shoot, this is only a 3.5 aperture. We're not even at 1.8 yet. Ah, that 1.8 lets in so much light, guys. It lets in so much light. Wow. And this is on autofocus, manual focus. You adapt it. That's how it sounds when you're messing with it. But I'm gonna turn the autofocus back on. I don't wanna mess with nothing. Wow, guys. It's just so like, it's good. It's so good. Oh wow, you guys are going to see all that stuff in the background, but it lets in so much light. Wow. This is worth it, guys. This is worth it. Oh my gosh, and that blur at f1.8. Now, this is like my first very low aperture lens, so it's crazy to see this in person. I don't know about y'all, man, but for me, this is crazy to see this in person, because it's just like, I'm so used to 3.5, the kit level lenses, but man, I was ready to get out of the shell and just get into like looking at lower apertures, working with the blur. And I know like the cool thing now is to shoot at like 2.8 at least, or like at f4, because you know, you're not really, because you know, that's what the pros are doing now. But man, I still love looking at that blur in the background and focusing on one subject and just taking the shot, you know. I love that. So man, and I can keep my ISO at least 100. It lets in so much light at 1.8. So for all the people who are switching from kit lenses and getting into that low aperture lens area, that f1.4, that f1.2, whew, at f1.8, it's worth it. So I don't even want to know what f1.2, f1.4 looks like. So guys, man, even with its low aperture, guys, it looks great, guys. It's just honestly, I can't ask for more with this 50mm 1.8 STM lens. Guys, it's just, whew, it lets in so much light. It's great. It's awesome, man. The quality is, it's just great. Nothing makes a great duo besides these two right here, guys. So really, get this 50mm 1.8 STM and get this Viltrox. You could get this on Amazon. And remember, this is a regular Viltrox. This is not the speed booster. This does not do anything special. It's the lens and it's the camera body. So the adapter just allows you to put this lens on this camera body. It doesn't do anything crazy special. It doesn't turn anything into a 100mm. No, it doesn't do none of that. It does its job, and that's to adapt. And we have the 50mm 1.8. You can pick these up from MPB. It's a great price. Look for the like new condition, and look for the excellent or good. I got this one in good, so far so good, you know. And again, I picked up this camera body from MPB as well. So man, they're not missing on this. They are not. Honestly, they are not. They haven't missed. So this just, it's great. The lens is great. The camera body is great. Viltrox adapter that came from Amazon, it works well. I haven't seen it mess with anything. It attached both of the products I needed to attach. So I just recommend it for you guys, man. And I'm going to take some pictures with this, so you guys stay tuned into the channel and keep watching the content, because man, I'm going to drop some bomb videos with the Canon M50 and some pretty nice dope photo shoots coming up. I'm working with a couple of people, and can't wait to show you guys what this little baby can do. So I will catch you guys next time on Dylan's Photography. Peace out, everyone.